Hi guys, and welcome to yet another very exciting Adobe Illustrator tutorial. And in this tutorial we are going to talk about the touch type tool. If you remember from previous tutorial when we were talking about the type panel in the character panel, I said we are going to talk about this button which says touch type tool later in its own tutorial. Well, the time is arrived now. You can select it from here, but I'm going to select it from somewhere else. But before that, I want to mention that these options which control the size of the text, you know, their leading, turning, you know, rotation and other stuff that I showed you, those all can be achieved with one tool, which is here with the text tool. You can select it from here, or you can select it from the character panel, or you can alternately click on Shift plus T on the keyboard to select it. Once you've selected it, just click on any character you want to modify, and then it will make this sort of a box over it, and then you can start adjusting it. I'm just gonna place the C in the middle so that it's visibly more clear to you guys. Okay, so now this is these 4 points and this 1 point, total 5 points, and all these points does different things. The first one, increase and decrease its size proportionally, you know, like this, you know. It increases it horizontally and vertically both equally. I am gonna control that. The second one here, only increase it horizontally. This option was also available in the type panel. This place on this corner, you know, change its baseline. You can put its baseline downwards, you can put it upwards, wherever you want. You can shift its baseline with this corner. And this point, you know, increase and decrease its horizontal, you know, size, if you want that, if you want the C to be, or the, any letter that you have to be of extra, you know, length, you can adjust it with this point. This point, of course, adjusts its, you know, rotation, and you can make your text really funky by using stuff like these on it, increasing maybe its horizontal length, something like that, and other stuff. You can also use these tags to change it to superscript. For example, I have selected this A, and now this can go up, but the option with this superscript is given with someone, some of them, but not with all of them. For example, it's given with A and I, but it's not given with H and C. Okay, so for example, like this, you can change it into superscript. And if you want to change it back, or okay, I'm gonna control Z that, actually like that, and so it's done like that. And also you can control the kerning between, or the visual space between two characters, by using the left and right arrow keys on your keyboard, like this and like this. So I'm gonna little bit bring it closer and bit rotate it a little. Okay, I'm gonna go to the next one. Actually, I'm gonna superscript it, and then I'll bring it closer to this one. I'm gonna change the rotation of the R, bring it down a little, actually here, with baseline, adjust it, increase the height of the I a little, decrease the height of the T a little, and rotate it also, and move the charity down or Y down. As you can see, I have made our word charity a lot more funkier than it looked before. So now our text reads charity starts at home. It's an illustration file that I picked up or downloaded from freepik.com. You can use this or any other of your own to practice this. Always remember that practice makes perfect. And this text reads charity starts at home. You should not always, you know, tell others to do good things, because you should start doing them yourself and show them the example, and then they will follow. That is more, you know, better ethic and moral point of view. So in this tutorial, you not only learned something about Adobe Illustrator, but also something about religion and ethics and doing good things to other people. So with that said, I hope you enjoy this tutorial. Now you know how to use the touch type tool. I will see you in the next tutorial, hopefully. Goodbye for now.